В Испании, Португалии, Франции, Италии, Германии, Австрии, Швейцарии.
The ruins of rock underground and megalithic towns are widely developed in Spain, Portugal, France, Italy, Germany, Austria, Switzerland, Bulgaria, Romania, Turkey, Israel, Jordan, Lebanon and other countries of the Mediterranean region. During my numerous expeditions from the year 210 to the year 217, I determined the time of their construction to the Neogene period. As a rule, these ancient ruins are overlapped by younger historical formations, which are explored in these regions by archaeologists and which are dated by them between the 10th millennium BC and the 1st millennium BC.
Парадокс еще заключается в том, что большинство археологов...
The paradox is that most archaeologists who work in this region do not allocate the ruins of rock underground and megalithic cities. More precisely, they do not allocate them as isolated complexes. They attribute them to the overlapping historical complexes, because these ruins carry no material remains. They carry no skeletal remains, no remains of ceramics, no remains of coals or wood. Therefore, their age cannot be determined directly with the help of archaeological methods only. The determination of the age of historical times overlapping ruins, which contain the remains of ceramics, coals and skeletal remains, is used. Those remains that are located in upper formations are interpolated to underlying rock, underground and megalithic complexes, and according to these remains, in my opinion, completely unreasonable and incorrect, their age is determined. Rock, underground and megalithic formations, which are spread everywhere, practically in all countries, cover huge areas that have dimensions from tens of square meters to tens of square kilometers and are developed almost everywhere. They are very much washed out, smooth with erosion, and overlying deposits cover them, as geologists say, with angular and stratigraphic unconformity, with pockets. As a result of the action of water and wind, these complexes have been destroyed, and overlapping structures were built on the destroyed and eroded surface.
Несогласие с карманами, где находятся как раз в результате действия воды, ветра, вот эти вот комплексы разрушались, и уже на разрушенную, на размытую вот эту поверхность строились перекрывающие их отложения.
The rock underground and megalithic structures, which we see in ruins, are present in different forms. Firstly, it is most often rock complexes that represent some sort of ledges, pits, foundation pits, wells, preserved towers, staircases, remains of rooms carved in rocks, which are very badly destroyed and covered with crusts of secondary minerals. Underground structures are also a separate type of formations that we can see in Israel, Turkey, Spain and other countries. We can see downward galleries with stairs, which are often littered with some later sediments and rubbish. Often they represent ruined mountains, inside of which we can see remnants of underground rooms. Many of them are still underground, others are partially destroyed. Their upper part is exposed in the air in the form of rock formations. Very often we cannot determine boundaries and differences between rock and underground complexes. Take for example the rock town of Tatlarin in Turkey. In the upper part it is a rock town, and in the lower part it is already a typical underground town consisting of several underground floors. Apparently, the upper part of it, called the rock town of Tatlarin, is nothing but the eroded underground town of Tatlarin, its upper floors. Thus, some of rock towns that we see now in mountains were formerly underground towns, although there are undoubtedly some purely rock towns. A variety of rock towns that we studied during the expedition to Turkey and which I then saw in the expeditions to Israel, Spain and in October 216 expedition to Italy, I called elven or elfish towns by analogy with the film The Lord of the Rings, The Chronicles of Narnia and others.
Несомненно, есть и чисто скальные города. И вот разновидность скальных городов, которые мы выделили во время экспедиции в Турцию, затем я их увидел в Израиле в экспедиции, затем увидел в экспедиции эти города в Испании, последняя экспедиция в октябре 2016 года в Италии, то есть таких городов очень много. Я их назвал эльфийские города по аналогии с фильмом «Властелин колец», «Хроники Нарнии» и другие. Что такое эльфийские города?
What are elven or elfish towns? This is probably the most interesting formations that I have ever met. Single mountains, table mountains with a flat, often slightly inclined tops in a form of plateaus. Flat tops of these mountains are separated from surrounding flat terrains by cliffs and often megalithic walls from large stone blocks on the edge of plateaus. Most of megalithic walls are destroyed and their blocks rolled down long ago. Nevertheless, some fragments of megalithic walls remained in the form of rock outliers, teeth and a kind of a saw. This is clearly seen in Pishmishkale, Akparakale, Great Yazilikaya and in the Phrygian Valley in Turkey and in a number of other places. On the plateaus there are excavated pits, wells, remnants of some stone rooms and walls with well distinguishable windows and doors, some very beautiful stone towns that are most often destroyed, tunnels going deep into the mountains. Many of the columns that adorned these towns rolled far down the slopes. The majority of them are already deeply submerged in the quaternary sediments. All this indicates the very great antiquity of these towns and structures.
Городов, этих городов и сооружений. И опять-таки в данном случае постоянно во всех этих эльфийских городах, так называемых, которые находятся на вершинах довольно высоких гор,
In all the elven towns, which are situated on the tops of high solitary mountains, there are tunnels that go down. That is, they were rock underground towns. Most likely, there were hollow mountains with rooms and halls under the tops. The Hobbit movie shows similar elven towns, which are very nice. Decorated houses on rocks, from which some staircases descended under the earth, and comfortable dwellings under the ground. The next type of the formations is submerged rock towns. One of them is located in Rosh Hanitra in the north of Israel, near the border with Lebanon. The most well-seen sunken town is situated in Kekova Bay in southern Turkey. It represents fragments of rooms carved in rock, fragments of walls, fragments of partitions. Sometimes fragments of roofs are visible and houses descended into the sea along faults. Since the sea here is clean, you can see that some of these structures are at great depth. However, some structures are still partially above the sea surface. The next type of the formation is megalithic or, as they are also called by archaeologists, cyclopean towns and structures consisting of large stone blocks. Such structures are owned in Baalbek in Lebanon, in the tunnel of Kotel under the Temple Mount in Jerusalem. At that, if in Lebanon there are blocks up to 2,000 tons, then under the Temple Mount the biggest block weighs 600 tons. All these lay on a quite a large depth. The remains of the megalithic wall are covered by later deposits. Taking into account that all megalithic blocks are overbuilt with the later masonry of Solomon Herod times, some archaeologists believe that the megalithic wall was built by Solomon, others consider that it was built by Herod and attributed to historical time. I was twice in the tunnel of Kotel and twice convinced that the megalithic wall has nothing to do with either Solomon's masonry or Herod's masonry, but is the creation of an older civilization. Herod and Solomon simply built their structures on these megalithic blocks. In the capital of the Hittite Empire of Hattusash in northern Turkey, I managed to explore magnificent megalithic ruins. They are very much destroyed. The upper part of them underwent the strongest water and wind erosion. You can see some ripped surfaces, pockets, torn pieces. All this shows that the megalithic city of Hattusash was built very, very long ago. In other places, the upper parts of megalithic blocks often have rounded outlines. This suggests that they were exposed to water and air too. I have already said that rock and underground structures are part of one complex, which 5 years ago I called an underground terrestrial megalithic complex. It can also be called a rock underground megalithic complex. Megalithic towns are often associated with rock towns. This is clearly seen in the Tunnel of Kotel. Megalithic blocks rest against rock, and then the rock begins to include some niches and rooms. It turns out as if one whole. In some places, I cannot even see the boundary between the megalithic blocks and the rock complex. Megalithic towns are often associated with rock towns. This is clearly seen in the Tunnel of Kotel. Megalithic blocks rest against rock, and then the rock begins to include some niches and rooms. It turns out as if one whole. In some places, I cannot even see the boundary between the megalithic blocks and the rock complex. Rectangular blocks weighing more than 100 tons rest on finished walls as if they were carved out of them. Further, for some good reasons, the construction of the megalithic wall from individual blocks began. Therefore, I call such complexes an underground terrestrial megalithic complex of ancient civilizations. This complex is absolutely identical in Portugal, Spain, Italy, Israel, Turkey, Bulgaria, Crimea, Lebanon, Jordan. And judging by what I saw in the photographs, in Germany, Austria, France, Romania, Georgia, Armenia, and many other countries. This complex is widely developed all over the Mediterranean region.